Today, we debunk 11 car myths. What is up, guys? Today, I'm going to go over 11 myths that I can't stand about cars. The first one is one of them that I hate the most, to be honest, and it's you have to change your oil every 3,000 miles. Today's oil is so advanced that you don't have to change your oil every 3,000, even every 5,000. Chances are that your vehicle has a maintenance minder system, which is a system that counts down in a percentage or something of the sorts that will alert you when it's time to change your oil. Most newer vehicles have them, and they can be very, very useful. Never, ever, ever just change your oil because somebody says you have to. Always listen to what the manufacturer recommends or what your car is telling you. It's all based on how you drive. Next is premium fuel will help my car's performance. This one is also false. Only run premium fuel if your car is meant to run it. If your car is meant to run 87, use 87. It won't increase your horsepower, it won't increase your gas mileage. All you're going to do is waste your money. American cars are made in America. This one's mostly false. While the bodies might be made here, a lot of the parts are outsourced from other countries. Just because you have an American-made car, such as a Ford or a Chevrolet, does not mean that they make the entire car in the USA. We could also say Japanese cars are made in Japan. That's also false. Take Honda, for example. 90% of the cars that Honda makes are made in the USA and Canada. Fourth on the list is to warm up your car before driving. On most newer vehicles of today, when you start your engine, you will almost instantaneously be getting oil into your bearings. Now, your car will run its best at operating temperature, but sitting in your driveway letting your car warm up to operating temperature is just wasting fuel and in turn, wasting your money. The fifth myth is there's no replacement for displacement. That's right, I said that is a myth. There's no replacement for displacement is a myth. This is also a funny one that all the boomers like to say. I have a V8, so that makes my engine that much better than yours. I have extra cylinders over what you have. It's false. Let's use my Mustang for example. I have a 98 Mustang GT with a 4.6 2-valve. From the factory, it comes with 225 horsepower. So let's take a 2005 Honda Odyssey as a second car. They come with a 3.5 V6 with 255 horsepower. Well, right there, that already has more horsepower. So let's break it down even further. With a simple equation, the Mustang has 49 horsepower per liter, and the Odyssey has 73 horsepower per liter. So that right there tells me that no replacement for displacement is bullshit. A manual transmission is faster than an auto. Maybe this was correct in the 60s, 70s, 80s, in that era, but today, with dual clutch transmissions, that is absolutely false. There is not a chance that a human is going to shift more precise and faster than an automatic transmission made today. Some of today's auto transmissions shift almost instantaneously and at the perfect RPM. This is a reason you see a lot of automatic transmissions in the drag racing world. At number 8 on our list, ABS shortens stopping distance. It actually does the complete opposite of that. ABS isn't meant to shorten your stopping distance. It's constantly pulsing your brakes, allowing your wheels to not lock up, and in turn allowing you to controllably steer while you brake. If you lock up your brakes and all of your wheels are skidding, it doesn't matter how much you turn your steering wheel, your car is going to continue straight until you either stop or hit something. Number 9, if you have a warranty, you have to take it to the dealer. This is completely false. It's your car, you could do whatever you want with it. If you want to fix it, you could fix it. If you want to change your oil, you can change your oil. You could take it to Valvoline, you could take it to anywhere to get your oil changed. You do not have to go to the dealership. The only time you're ever really going to need to take your car to the dealership is if you have a recall or something in the warranty period breaks and it's covered. Other than that, take it to wherever you want. Inflate your tires to the pressure on the sidewall. A lot of people are under the assumption that you have to set your tire pressures to whatever the tire says. This is wrong. This is merely just your max load rating at a certain weight. Set your tire pressures to the manufacturer's recommendation. You could usually find the sticker inside your door jamb. It'll be yellow, sometimes white, whatever. It'll have your tire size, the pressures front and rear, other useful information. Always consult the manufacturer. foreign cars cost more to maintain. Let's take a look at this website, shall we? So this website shows different cars over their lifetime and how much it costs to maintain them. This website shows the most expensive car to maintain on the list is the Chrysler Sebring at $17,100. In second is a BMW and third is a Nissan. So I'm not sure if I read that correctly, but as far as I'm aware, a Chrysler Sebring is not a foreign car. And the final myth on our list is too much PSI is bad. When someone says I wouldn't run more than 7 PSI on that engine, they are straight wrong. The amount of boost isn't the problem, it's the CFM. 7 PSI on a 2871R and 7 PSI on a 3871R are two completely different 7 PSI numbers. It's not the PSI that hurts the engine, it's the horsepower. That is it for my list. Hopefully I can debunk some myths for you. So when your friends try to trick you and tell you all this mumbo jumbo, you could prove them wrong. That is it for me today. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.